this year, we're hoping to do it in under 9 days if we get average weather. Well, at 9 days even is like 325 miles a day or so. So that means at our riding speed with some brakes and things in there, you're pretty much on the bike for 20 hours a day or so. And then you waste some time, you know, getting off for some brakes and then maybe 3 hours or so of actual sleeping per night. So we're trying to average between 18 and 20 miles an hour while we're riding. I guess it's just where you set your expectations. The first time I rode across it took 12 days, 18 hours, and then it went to 10 days, 23 hours, and then 9 days, 20 hours. And it's just like, well, I know I can go, I can do it in 10 days, so that's where we set our standards at. And we'll try to improve on that. Susan's the best person I think I could have picked, you know, as a partner. As in life and also as a partner in doing the cross-country type ride. So I think we get along pretty well.
Is this going to put an undue strain on your relationship starting off?
No, I think actually we get along pretty well when we're under pressure situations.
How have you prepared for that?
Mostly it's been 3 months of just riding with Lon up in northern Illinois. The weather hasn't been very cooperative, so we don't have as many miles in as we'd like, but we've ridden maybe close to 50 to 100 miles a day for the last 3 months.
How about your marriage? The state of your marriage, is going to put a strain on it?
We've been married less than 2 weeks now, and I think that this is a grueling experience for any two people, whether they're male and male or female and female or God forbid, married people. But I think that we know each other really well, and we've agreed that if we yell and scream that at the end it's over.
And there's no sense being hyper nervous. All we're going to do is just go out and roll.
Have tried to do, you know, with our trip today is that we'd like to bring an awareness for the prevention of child abuse.
I definitely think they're doing it for a good cause.
That you do affect children every day just by whether they're your neighbor's kids or whether they're your kids or whether they're your sister's or brother's kids, and that we all have to help protect their state of happiness.
Susan and I think, came from real supporting families, and our parents have been involved in their crews, and they've just helped us out with whatever we wanted to do. And having that support from home has been real important for us. That the children have dreams too, and don't try to send them down a straight and narrow path. Try to give the children some support. That whatever limitations we set, we can always almost go beyond those. The physical part of this event is probably equivalent to doing like a triathlon every day. And just to do it one day would be very difficult, but to do it 9 to 10 times in a row, or running something like 40 marathons within a period of 10 days is pretty difficult. And then still doing that on anywhere from 3 to 4 hours sleep per night, and then still eating probably the equivalent of 4 to 5 Thanksgiving dinners every day, which is between 7 and 10,000 calories. And then there are times when you're sick and you can't eat and you still have to ride 300 miles a day and about the equivalent of a bowl of cereal. That's about how much food you put down. So you do have to be able to run on empty quite a few times, and also be able to put down a lot of food and metabolize that food. And that's really the key to a marathon athlete, is how well they can metabolize their food and just keep going.
When they are hurting or when they need help, you pull the energy out of somewhere, just as they're pulling the energy out of somewhere to keep going.
37 hours on the bike brought Lon and Sue from Santa Monica, California to Gallup, New Mexico, a total of 682 miles. Before taking their first sleep break. And then they only slept for 1 hour. Now they were pushing on to Albuquerque. Their goal was to make it to New York in 9 days even, and break Lon's world record of 9 days, 20 hours. At this pace, they would easily attain their goal. After another short rest stop near Santa Rosa, they were pressing on into the dawn of day 4 and the windy plains of Texas. The 35-mile-an-hour tailwind seemed a blessing at first, as it was helping them make phenomenal time. The result was disastrous. With no breeze coming from the front, and with Sue blocking the wind from behind, Lon became dangerously overheated. They were forced to stop and work to reduce his temperature.
Even though I've done a lot of riding, I've never seen anything like this before. In that sense, I'm worried. It's incredible. I can't believe how hard they're pushing themselves, and it seems way beyond human capabilities, and to know that they're going to be doing this for 2,000 more miles is incredible.
Somehow they gathered the strength to get up and go on, this time Susan taking the front position. But Lon was not recovering, and by nightfall in Texahoma, the crew decided to take drastic measures and immersed his overheated body in a bath of ice. The normal metabolism might have required a week of convalescing, but within 14 hours, Lon was up and they were on the road again, pushing on to make up for lost time. By the fifth day, they were entering Missouri, Susan's home state. Although she didn't let on to all the people who had come out to support them, Susan was developing severe abdominal pain.
It'll be pretty nice until Athens, Ohio, and then we start climbing in the Appalachians, and that'll be the worst part.
That'll be the worst part until you get back to New York?
That'll be the worst part.
That'll be the worst part of the whole trip.
Right, it's Athens.
Two and a half days later in Athens, Ohio, the crisis peaked.
The stop was made primarily to give Susan a chance to be evaluated for severe fatigue, dehydration, and a 3 or 4 day bout with acute viral gastroenteritis. She was obviously fatigued. She's an excellently conditioned athlete, but she was suffering from the rigors of approximately 8 days on the bicycle, with the last 3 or 4 of those days being quite sick and yet continuing in spite of her illness.
On the other side of Clarksburg, get back on the old highway, which is horrible.
With their second major setback behind them, they pushed on. But New York was still 573 miles away. Now, even breaking the existing tandem record of 10 days, 21 hours, and 49 minutes seemed out of reach. On through beautiful but very hilly West Virginia they pressed, beginning once more to gain momentum. By the ninth day, they were moving on through the Pennsylvania countryside. But little did they know that a storm was moving in and the worst was yet to come.
And it's raining and I can't see where I'm going and it's dangerous and I've got other things to do besides kill myself.
When that happened, it totally scared me. It really threw a fright on me.
Just 65 miles out of New York, they could go no further.
Real emotional for everyone. I want Lon and Susan to do what they want to do.
That's their decision to make. You know, they're the ones that have to ride it with all this truck traffic. It's going to be very, very difficult.
It doesn't really matter, you know, if we don't do it. The thing that matters is that they've come so far through so many difficult situations and have managed to come so close to beating the record. That says it all right there. I mean, they've been down more time on this trip than I can believe.
The morning light diminished some of the danger, and Lon and Sue pulled their tired bodies from the RV. Still, there were hazardous road conditions and heavy New York traffic ahead. Drawn by their commitments to themselves and to the children, they decided to take a chance.
If you change your mind,
take a chance.
I'm the first in line.
Take a chance.
Honey, I'm still free.
Take a chance
on me.
Take a chance.
If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around.
Take a chance.
If you got no place to go when you're feeling down.
Days, 20 hours, and 23 minutes after leaving Los Angeles, Lon and Susan Haldeman rolled across the New York City finish line. Setting the new world's record.